Hello friends, let us learn a new topic today, which is about perinephric abscess. So perinephric abscess is formation of abscess around the kidney. So if you see, if this is the kidney, then there is abscess somewhere around the kidney, right? So this is perinephric abscess. So what are the causes of perinephric abscess? One, infection of perinephric hematoma. Okay, that is one. So let me draw a diagram and I will illustrate all the causes in this diagram. So this is the kidney. This is the ureter. So this is the arterial supply, renal artery, and then renal vein. So now first, infection from the perinephric hematoma. Next, second, perforation of the perforation through renal capsule. From pyonephrosis, or renal carbuncle. From renal carbuncle, there may be perforation through the renal capsule. So this is one. From here, it might perforate here. That is one type. And then third, there may be tuberculous perinephric abscess. And fourth, it may be an extension from cortical abscess. The cortical abscess may extend downwards. Extension of cortical abscess. And then it can be an extension from appendicular abscess may extend up and form this perinephric abscess. That is fifth, extension of appendicular abscess. And then finally, it can be due to hematogenous spread, or it can be periurethral lymphatic spread. So these are the different types of causes for the perinephric abscess. So now, what are the clinical features that you see in perinephric abscess? The clinical features, the major clinical features include high swinging pyrexia, and you see abdominal tenderness, and also fullness in the loin. The signs include, signs generally present early if infection is in lower part. If infection is in upper pole, it is masked by the ribs. Because of the ribs, the infection is masked and thus it is not much seen. So WBC count is always raised. Then there are no pus cells or organisms in urine. If you have to do investigations, the best investigation is abdominal radiograph, that is X-ray KUB, that is kidney, ureter and bladder. Then in this you see obliteration of psoas shadow due to the presence of this abscess. Psoas shadow is obliterated, and there is scoliosis. and elevation of diaphragm may be seen. Elevation of hemidiaphragm because of the pus. And if you do intravenous urethrogram or urogram, sorry, intravenous urogram, it is normal. You will do two films, one in erect posture and the other in lying down posture. So one in erect posture and the other in lying down posture. If you do in erect posture, it is normal. If you do in lying down posture, you will see downward displacement of kidney is seen. Okay. Is not seen in erect posture. In erect posture, normally here you do two films, one in erect posture and the other in lying down posture. In erect posture, you will not see the downward displacement of ribs. Normally you see downward displacement of kidney is seen normally. Downward displacement of kidney is seen normally. In IVU, this in erect posture, downward displacement of the kidney is not seen because of the perinephric abscess. So this is called as Mathies sign. In Mathies sign, in erect posture, when this person is like this, then downward displacement of kidney is not seen. In erect posture, normally you see downward displacement of kidney. This not whenever this downward displacement of kidney is not seen, then this is called as Mathies sign. So generally in intravenous urogram, you do two films. One is in erect posture and the other is in lateral posture. If you do a film in erect posture normally, you see downward displacement of kidney. If you do this in erect posture in this perinephric abscess, then you will not see the downward displacement of kidney. So this not seeing the downward displacement of kidney is called as Mathies sign. Okay. Next, ultrasound abdomen can also be done. This will show us the abscess. Then how do you treat it? The best treatment is open drainage of abscess. This is by Loyne approach. Lumbar incision. Now if you see, if this is the thing and here you are giving an incision in the loin, okay, and you are opening it, and this incision should be this lumbar incision. This should be large enough to open pockets of pus. All the pockets of pus should be opened. So it should be large enough for that. Okay. So this is how you drainage the abscess. And then a malakoff catheter is placed for drainage of pus later. Is kept in place. Okay, so this is about perinephric abscess. So in our next class we will learn about renal tuberculosis. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. If you have any doubts, please comment it in the comment section. If you feel something is inadequate, even then comment it in the comment section. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.